Vast carpets of bluebells turn our woodlands into floral oceans in late spring and early summer. In Irish mythology, it was believed that you could call on the fairy folk if the flower bells were rung. And it is thought to be unlucky to walk through them, as the plants were full of spells. Bluebells are certainly enchanting, but what many people are not aware of is that our bluebells are changing. The bluebell is native to western parts of Atlantic Europe, but it is at its highest population density in Britain and Ireland, which is thought to harbour between 25 and 50% of the global native population. This means that we have a duty to protect our populations, especially given our low woodland cover. However, humans have introduced another species of bluebell to Ireland, the Spanish bluebell, which, as the name suggests, is only native to Spain and Portugal. When the Spanish bluebell grows close to populations of our native bluebell, they will cross-pollinate, producing a fertile hybrid known as Hyacinthoides ex Massartiana. The X in the name indicates that it is a hybrid. It is not currently known how widespread this hybrid is in Ireland, or, importantly, what impact it will have on our native bluebell populations. So, when you're out walking in the Irish countryside and you come across bluebells, how can you tell whether they are the native, Spanish, or a hybrid? Well, for this we look at a number of key features: the shape and size of the leaves, the arrangements of the flower upon the stem, the colour and shape of the flower themselves, and the colour of the pollen. Let's look at the native plant first. You can see that the leaves are quite thin and narrow. The colour of the flowers is deep purple, and the flowers are all arranged on one side of the stem, nodding downwards. The flower itself is quite closed and tubular, with the petals curling right back at the tip. Now, when we look inside the flower, we can see that the pollen on the anthers is a creamy colour. And if we take a sniff, we get that beautiful sweetish scent that fills our woodlands this time of year. Now, when we look at the Spanish bluebell, we can see that it is a much bigger beast than our daintier native bluebell. The leaves are large and fleshy. The flowers are a much paler colour than our native, and are arranged around the stem in a conical shape. The petals are much more open than our native plant. Let's look inside the flower again. The pollen on the anthers is blue and not creamy like the native. However, the longer the flower is open, it will lose this pollen, and the anthers may appear creamy, just like the native. Finally, let's take a sniff. There is little or no scent. So, now we know that the native and Spanish bluebell are quite easy to tell apart. But what about the hybrid? Well, like most hybrids, the physical appearance can vary greatly depending on how much of each parent plant is in the ancestry. But there are a few clues in the physical features to help us. First off, the plants here look much taller and the leaves slightly bigger than the native. Also, the flowers lack the deep purple coloration of the native plant. Now, flower arrangement can be all to one side, like in the native species, or all around the stem, like in the Spanish bluebell, or even a combination of both. Also, flower position can be somewhat upright in the hybrid, and not all nodding downwards, like in the native species. You can see the flower petals are more open, like the Spanish bluebell. Now again, we look inside the flower. The pollen on the anthers here is somewhat creamy, similar to the native bluebell. However, when there is more of the Spanish bluebell in the ancestry, it can appear a pale green colour. And when we smell them, there is only a very faint scent, or no scent at all. So there you have it, the three shades of blue that grace our woodlands and hedgerows. When you are out walking in the Irish countryside in May, be sure to take a closer look at your bluebells and submit your sightings to either of the websites on screen now. Your records will help track this subtle and unseen change happening in the environment, and hopefully native bluebells will continue to enchant visitors to our woodlands long into the future.